Welcome to the Shikasa Bu Motor Channel. This channel provides easy-to-understand explanations of car mechanisms. In Japan, the Toyota Corolla is available with either a gasoline engine model or a hybrid model, both equipped with a 1.5-liter naturally aspirated engine. This is a comparison of fuel economy under the WLTC mode. The unit is kilometers per liter. It's clear that the hybrid model has overwhelmingly superior fuel economy. In the USA, the Honda Civic is available with either a gasoline engine model or a hybrid model, both equipped with a 2.0-liter naturally aspirated engine. This is a comparison of EPA fuel economy. The unit is miles per gallon. Like Toyota, Honda's hybrid models also far outperform their gasoline engine counterparts. In the UK, the Peugeot 208 is available with either a gasoline engine model or a hybrid model, both equipped with a 1.2-liter turbo engine. This is a comparison of WLTC fuel economy. The unit is liters per 100 kilometers. As you can see, even though both the gasoline and hybrid models are equipped with basically the same engine structure, there is a significant difference in their fuel economy. This video explains three reasons why hybrids achieve better fuel economy. The cooperation between the gasoline engine and the electric motor, regenerative braking, and the Atkinson and Miller cycle engine. These graphs show the output curves of a typical gasoline engine and an electric motor. Gasoline engines produce their highest torque in the mid-speed range, while electric motors produce their highest torque at low speeds. This can be rephrased as saying that they are most efficient within those speed ranges. Hybrid systems achieve excellent fuel economy by using the engine and electric motor mostly within their most efficient speed ranges. Let's take a look at how each system from Toyota, Honda, and Peugeot operates. Toyota's hybrid system consists of an engine, MG1, a planetary gear-type power split device, and MG2. MG stands for motor generator. During launch and low-speed driving, the vehicle is driven solely by the electric motor. In other words, the system avoids the operating range where the gasoline engine is least efficient, and uses the electric motor, which operates most efficiently at low speeds. When the vehicle speed exceeds a certain level, the gasoline engine starts and drives the vehicle. At this time, MG1 and the planetary gear function as a CVT, continuously variable transmission, maintaining the engine speed within its most efficient range while varying the vehicle speed according to the driver's accelerator input. For this reason, Toyota's hybrid system delivers excellent fuel efficiency across the entire speed range. This channel presents a video explaining the details of this system. If you are interested, please have a look. The link is in the description. Honda's hybrid system consists of an engine, a generator, an electric motor, and a direct drive clutch. From launch to medium speeds, the gasoline engine is dedicated to driving the generator, while the electric motor solely propels the vehicle. In principle, the engine operates only within its high-efficiency speed range, achieving excellent fuel economy. The efficiency of electric motors decreases in the high-speed range. For this reason, during highway driving, the direct drive clutch engages to connect the engine to the output shaft, allowing the vehicle to be propelled by the engine. This channel presents a video explaining the details of this system. If you are interested, please have a look. The link is in the description. Peugeot's hybrid system adds an engine disconnect clutch and an electric motor to the conventional gasoline engine powertrain. From launch to low speeds, the engine disconnect clutch is disengaged, and the vehicle is propelled solely by the electric motor. When the vehicle speed exceeds a certain level, the engine disconnect clutch engages, and the system operates in the same manner as a conventional gasoline-powered vehicle. However, when strong acceleration is required, the electric motor assists the gasoline engine. Since Peugeot's hybrid system uses a 48-volt electrical architecture, it cannot employ a high-output electric motor, resulting in a narrower electric-only driving range compared with Toyota's and Honda's systems. Therefore, although Peugeot's hybrid models offer better fuel economy than their gasoline counterparts, the improvement is smaller compared with other hybrid systems. This graph shows the fuel economy of each hybrid model, with the fuel economy of the corresponding gasoline engine model set at 100. Peugeot, which has a small electric motor, delivers excellent fuel economy at low speeds, but offers no advantage from hybridization at high speeds. This system is also used in other brands within the Stellantis group, such as Citroën, Fiat, Alfa Romeo, and Jeep. This channel presents a video explaining the details of this system. If you are interested, please have a look. The link is in the description. When electricity is supplied to an electric motor, it rotates. When an external force is applied to rotate an electric motor, it generates electricity. Regenerative braking is a system that uses this principle to decelerate a vehicle. The electricity generated by regenerative braking is stored in the battery. A hybrid vehicle is cruising at a constant speed on its gasoline engine. The battery is almost empty. When the driver releases the accelerator pedal or presses the brake pedal, the engine disconnect clutch is disengaged. The electric motor is driven by the rotation of the wheels, operating as a generator and producing electricity. The electricity generated charges the battery. The resistance of the generator slows down the vehicle, bringing it to a stop. At this time, the regenerative brake and the front and rear wheel friction brakes are coordinated. When the driver presses the accelerator pedal, the electric motor uses electricity from the battery to start and accelerate the vehicle. That means after regenerative braking, the vehicle can accelerate again without using a single drop of gasoline. Thanks to this operation, hybrid vehicles achieve particularly high fuel efficiency in city driving, where frequent starts and stops occur. However, when driving at a constant speed on a highway, the benefits of regenerative braking are limited. If you'd like to learn more about regenerative braking, please check out these videos. You'll find the links in the description. As you all know, gasoline engines operate by repeatedly performing four cycles: intake, compression, expansion, and exhaust. The piston's travel distance is always the same. Therefore, the ratio of air compression and the ratio of expansion of the compressed air are identical. An engine that operates in this manner is called an auto cycle engine. In this engine, since the piston stroke during the compression and expansion strokes is the same, exhaust gases that still have enough energy to push the piston downward are discharged. To address this issue, the Atkinson cycle engine, featuring different piston strokes for the compression and expansion strokes, was invented in 1887. With this mechanism, the energy of the combustion gases can be utilized without waste, improving engine efficiency and fuel economy. However, as you can see, this engine has many moving parts, making it unsuitable for automotive applications that require high-speed operation. The Miller cycle engine, developed in 1957, reduced the effective intake and compression strokes of a conventional engine by altering the timing of the intake valve opening and closing. Modern engines for hybrid vehicles adopt this system. In this system, the actual intake air volume is reduced, so the output is lower compared to an auto cycle engine of the same displacement. To compensate for this, the 1957 Miller cycle engine was equipped with a supercharger, while modern hybrid vehicles use an electric motor to assist the relatively weak engine. Under normal driving conditions, the vehicle is powered by a fuel-efficient but low-power engine. And when more output is needed, the electric motor provides assistance using electricity stored in the battery from regenerative braking. This is the third reason why hybrid vehicles achieve good fuel efficiency. This channel provides a detailed video explaining the Atkinson cycle and Miller cycle engines. If you're interested, please check it out. The link is in the description. By the way, automakers refer to their hybrid engines as either Atkinson cycle or Miller cycle engines. Since engines with complex linkages are classified as Atkinson cycle, and supercharged engines as Miller cycle. Strictly speaking, the engines used in hybrid vehicles are neither true Atkinson cycle nor true Miller cycle. What exactly do they base their naming on? Toyota, which developed the world's first hybrid vehicle, referred to it as an Atkinson cycle engine until around the mid-2010s. However, even though the mechanism hasn't changed, it has been referred to as a Miller cycle engine in recent years. There's probably no standard. It's simply a matter of the person in charge's preference. As an exception, Peugeot's engine is turbocharged, so it can be considered a genuine Miller cycle engine. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to the channel. We'll see you in the next video.